Rodgers is going to begin to take off and then fire, and it's caught. Touchdown, James Jones. As Charles has a huge lane inside the 20. Walker's in front, and he's in for the touchdown.
Ike, we got the Chiefs and the Packers coming up on Monday night. The Chiefs coming off that crushing loss to the Broncos. They should have won that game.
Should have, could have, would have,
but
right?
But we move on to week three.
Right.
We're previewing it. You have a key for each team, so let's start with the Kansas City Chiefs. What's your key to a win for them?
Alex Smith got to keep throwing the ball down the field.
He never really throws it like
that,
though.
But
that's four not
for,
a style.
He's 4 for 24 since 2014, but at the same time, now you picked up Jeremy Maclin. At least let me see what my engine, my Ferrari, working with down the field. So I'm going to try a couple of times, see if I can get a flag, see if he can make a play for me. Do something. Chunk the ball down the field.
So you mentioned Jeremy Maclin. They obviously have him there now. But do you think the reason why they weren't throwing it down the field before was because they didn't have a guy like Jeremy Maclin there?
Nah, regardless, I feel like you still can. You know what I'm saying? It's, as an offensive coordinator, you're telling your receivers, hey, if we're not getting a pass interference or if we're not coming down with the ball, make sure the cornerback doesn't come down with the ball either. So at least give it a shot, I would say.
Mm-hmm. And that helps things with Jamal Charles as well.
No question. So Jamal doesn't have to be your second leading receiver on on the offense. You still got Kelce. He can run down the seams. You have options, you know. Picking up Jeremy Maclin is a good option to go deep. So why not try him a few times?
All right, let's go to the other side of things, to the mm-hmm. Packers. I mean, it seems like they just keep winning. They're now 2-0. What do they need to do to beat the Chiefs?
Man, I say just keep feeding Starks. You know, depending on if Eddie Lacy is available or not, man, keep feeding the young man Starks, man. He's always been solid. He's always been productive. 95 yards, the second most in his career. I'm sure, man, he's looking at that stat. He want to hit 100. So
yeah.
Why not?
He's averaging 4.4 yards per carry right now. But Green Bay, you look at their weapons that they have. This is their backup running back, pretty much. When you have Eddie Lacy in there and then you have James Starks, why would you even push it with Lacy?
That's a good point. You know, depending on Lacy's situation as far as, like, injury, I wouldn't push it. You know, I'm going to go ahead and just wait till he gets healthy. I'm going to let James Starks, man, just ride it out to my number one comeback.
All right, do you have a prediction for us? If not, that's all right. I know I'm kind of just throwing this on you right
yeah.
now, but you can wait it out.
I'm going to go with A-Rod.
You're going with the Packers.
A-Rod, that guy right now, man. He discount double-checking everybody right now, so I'm going to go with A-Rod.
All right, so the Packers, they move to 3-0 in week 3. For all your updates leading up to Monday Night Football, just check out NFL Now.